A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th April, on the front page you have Election Commission puts on hold release of biopic on PM Modi. So this is regarding the movie on Prime Minister Narendra Modi starring Vivek Oberoi. So this had been cleared by Supreme Court, but now Election Commission has put its release on hold. So it prohibits release of all publicity material. That's under the Model Code of Conduct. Then this is Supreme Court rejects Centre's plea to keep Rafael documents secret. So this is regarding the Rafael deal case before the Supreme Court. So now the Supreme Court is going to hear the review pleas against its judgment upholding the Rafael defence deal. So it was petitioned in the Supreme Court that how documents which were given by the Centre to the Supreme Court were misunderstood and the judgment was given in favour of the Rafael deal. The government also filed a correction saying that what it submitted did not mean that CAG had approved it, but it is going to be approved by CAG. The deal as such will be reviewed by the CAG. So we'll see now. The Supreme Court has now rejected Centre's plea to keep Rafael documents secret. The central government said that Rafael documents have to be kept secret. The price cannot be revealed because otherwise it will help the enemy nations as such to, you know, the adverse nation, adversaries as such to understand, you know, that what weaponry do we have. So that was the reason being given, and also it said that for the deal between India and France, we have to keep this a secret, while later France had said that there is no such requirement. So all that is there. Now Supreme Court has rejected Centre's plea to keep Rafael documents secret. Already we have seen that the many official documents have come to the fore, and so Hindu has given an exclusive coverage of those, showing what were the changes which were made, the divergence which were done from the defense procurement procedure, you know, operating procedure, the standard contract as such which should be there, the standard contract document. So all this is there. So this is the image which has been revealed, a first ever image of a black hole. So it has been made of a black hole. So this has been done after assembling data gathered by a network of radio telescopes around the world. And this image was released by astronomers of Event Horizon Telescope. So the term black hole, you should know, was coined by John Archibald Wheeler. So it referred to a point in space where matter is so compressed as to create a gravity field from which even light cannot escape. So the more the mass, the bigger will be the hole. And you can see, so it was also been, the black hole has been theorized by Albert Einstein in 1915 to explain the law of gravity and their relation to other forces. And now we are having the first image as such being released. Then below you have May expresses regret for Jallianwala Bagh firing. So this is British Prime Minister Theresa May, who has expressed regret in Parliament over the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, which was also covered in news yesterday. So this, you should know, is important event in history because 2019 is the 100th anniversary of Jallianwala Bagh massacre. It happened on 13th April 1919. And below you have freed scribe vows to carry on free fight for free speech. So this is a scribe from Assam, but you can see Kishore Chandra Wangkhem. So he is a 39-year-old television anchor who was released from prison after 4 months. He was charged of sedition under National Security Act, and it was because he called the Chief Minister a puppet of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So that is why on sedition charges he was jailed for 4 months. After being released, he said that he'll continue fighting for free speech, and he also said that I'll continue fighting for scrapping of AFSPA too. On page 5 you have two idols stolen from Tamil Nadu temple now in Australia, South Africa. So police are now taking steps to bring them back to Kallirai Kodichi, the temple from where it was stolen in Tamil Nadu. On page 6 you have Supreme Court Collegium recommends 5 new Chief Justices of High Courts. So this recommendation has been for Chief Justices in Rajasthan, Kerala, Meghalaya, Andhra Pradesh and Chhattisgarh High Courts. So these names have been forwarded to the central government, which has to approve them so that the appointments can take place. On page 7 you have Supreme Court refuses to grant bail to Lalu. So this is regarding the fraud scam in which Lalu Prasad Yadav has been jailed. So now the bail as such for him has also been rejected. And this is anonymity of poll bonds must go, Election Commission. So protecting the identity of donors, which the central government insists on, is important. The Election Commission says that this must go, so that transparency is brought in the electoral bonds. And this is, how can Google Pay operate without authorization, asks High Court. So the Delhi High Court has questioned the RBI, how could Google's mobile payment app Google Pay operate in India as a payment transaction system without the requisite authorization. So it has, the Delhi High Court has asked for immediate end to the operations of Google Pay. Then on editorial page, the first editorial is Rafael rebuff. So this is regarding the front page news today, that Supreme Court has said there can be no secrecy in the Rafael deal details. So it was actually investigative journalism spearheaded by the Hindu newspaper which brought out the details. So now Supreme Court's decision, it is said, exposes attempts by the government to delegitimize investigative journalism. And below you have Dantewada ambush, which is the front page news of yesterday, the incident which happened in Chhattisgarh. The Maoists had actually killed a BJP MLA and from Dantewada, and also 4 security personnel. The lead article, trickeries of the money bill. So this is regarding the judgment in the tribunal's case which the Supreme Court will give. So it is the Revenue Bars Association versus Union of India case, in which the validity of Finance Act of 2017 insofar as it affects the structure and functioning of various judicial tribunals is under challenge. So this judgment of the Supreme Court will have profound bearing on India's constitutional arrangement, is stated, because there are many tribunals which are functioning, like National Green Tribunal, Income Tax Appellate Tribunal, National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, Industrial Disputes Tribunals, etc. So actually the petitioners argue that the judicial independence is important, and what has been done is that the government, through amendment to the provisions for the tribunals, it amended the Finance Act of 2017. So through that amendment, through this insertion of provisions under Finance Act, it actually abolished some tribunals and also altogether repealed the standards provided in different laws for the tribunals. And it made a law which vested the central government with absolute untrampled power to make rules to effectively govern operation of tribunals. So this may sound a death knell for tribunals. So Supreme Court had also observed that there are many tribunals in the country. They don't even make appointments. So there should be consolidation of tribunals, which was an observation which was uncalled for. But that is the case. So this is a very important article. Then below you have forcing China's hand. So this is regarding US initiative to have Masood Azhar blacklisted at UN Security Council through another route. So this marks a new turn, US supporting India against China. Then on the op-ed page, you can skip it. On page 10 again, you have the coverage on the Rafael deal, the entire development so far in the case. And this is RTI Act supersedes official secrets law. So this is regarding the RTI Act, and Justice K.M. Joseph has observed in a separate judgment that ordinary citizens have been given priceless right to demand information even in matters affecting national security and relations with foreign states. On international page you have capturing a trap where matter, space and time come to an end. So astronomers have now clicked an image of a black hole with the help of 8 radio telescopes on 6 mountains and 4 continents across the world. So this is the front page, regarding the front page image. So Event Horizon Telescope actually released this photograph of a black hole. Then below you have labor calls for full apology. So this is regarding Jallianwala Bagh massacre. What UK government has so far done is has expressed regret on this colonial past, but Labour Party in UK demands full apology. And here you have Zambian villagers get quotes nod to sue Vedanta. So Vedanta mines as such has these copper mines which are being it's a subsidiary of Vedanta which operates these copper mines. So the Zambia, an African country, has actually, the villagers here have dragged Vedanta to court. They have approached the court in UK over allegations relating to pollution of a river here in Zambia. And Britain's Supreme Court actually rejected an attempt by the company to challenge the jurisdiction of British courts. So Vedanta challenged this jurisdiction, but that was rejected by Supreme Court. So this is an important case which is going on now in UK. Then on business page you have SL Woes cast a shadow over Kotak FMP repayment. So this is regarding Kotak Mahindra Mutual Fund. So SL is the Z group, SL Z group of companies. So here the problem which has been faced because of delay in recovering money invested in SL Z group companies. So the HDFC Mutual Fund has also extended its FMP scheme here. On page 14 you have IRDAI tells insurers to notify claim status to customers. So this is regarding Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. It has directed all insurers to notify policyholder status of their claims at various stages of proceedings. So this is a move by the regulatory body to usher in transparency in settlement of claims. And this is Commerce Ministry for law to ban making sale of e-cigarettes. So now sale and making of e-cigarettes has been banned. Imports cannot be banned in absence of legislation. So that is what the Commerce Ministry says. And this is SEBI fiat to stockbrokers using artificial intelligence applications. So now SEBI has said that such stockbrokers must state if artificial intelligence and, you know, any machine learning tools are being used by them and whether they comply with cyber security norms. On the last page you have smokers spent $700 billion on cigarettes in 2017. So this is World Health Organization, which says that 250 times more than what we need to protect human health has actually been spent on cigarettes. And this is report reveals growing risk of cloud platform. So cyber criminals, it is said, attempted attacks on a Mumbai cloud server honeypot more than 6,78,000 times in a month, which is second to Ohio in US. So which recorded 9,50,000 login attempts by cyber criminals. So this is the growing risk to cloud platforms, you know, which is being highlighted. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com, download the PDFs for current affairs too, monthly, daily, as well as enroll for the full current affairs video lectures. Thank you.